The Marine Corps' Expeditionary Modular Autonomous Vehicle, Emav, will soon have significant firepower at its disposal. As reported by Military.com, the Marine Corps Warfighting Lab is working on deploying a machine gun turret and a specialized launcher for kamikaze or suicide drones on Expeditionary Modular Autonomous Vehicle. A prototype is being worked on. That essentially means that Emav could have a much larger role to play in the future. Viewers may note that Marine Corps Warfighting Lab is in charge of various aspects of advanced techniques and technology in the United States Marine Corps, and is also responsible for overseeing the Urban Warrior Program. In this video, Defense Updates reports on arming Expeditionary Modular Autonomous Vehicle, EMAV, with machine gun and drones. Let's get started. 1xBet is the sponsor of this video. It's a global bookmaker company through which you can place bets on Barcelona, Liverpool, Chelsea, and other football teams. They provide big winnings, quick payouts, and this is the most reliable bookmaker. There are bets not only on sports, but also on esports. The process is simple. Sign up, make a deposit. Use my personal promo code, DefenseU, and get a bonus of up to $100, and play with my partner. There will be a Champions League soon. This is an excellent occasion to bet on a team that you're sure of victory. Expeditionary Modular Autonomous Vehicle is being developed to support U.S. ground troops. EMAV program was first established in 2017 to haul ammo and supplies for infantry Marines. It's a highly mobile, multi-purpose, unmanned ground vehicle that can navigate on its own or be remotely operated. In the fully autonomous mode, it can avoid obstacles and reach the desired location independently. It has a payload capacity of 7,000 pounds and a range of 50 miles. Since it's compact in size, the system can be transported inside an MV-22 Osprey. EMAV is built to be a multi-purpose platform from the beginning, and hence it can accommodate several types of add-on modules, like a command and control, communications, computers, intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance, C4ISR, and electronic warfare systems. It's now that the system is being loaded to have its own offensive firepower. In August, Marines from Kilo Company, 3rd Battalion, 8th Marines, put the EMAV through its paces. The exercise was executed alongside with other next-generation gear at Muscatatuck Urban Training Center in Indiana, as part of the Project Metropolis. Project Metropolis is aimed at getting the Marines ready for future battles with new tactics and equipment. One of the additions was to deploy a machine gun. For this purpose, a 50 caliber gun was mounted on a common remotely operated weapon station, or CROWS. This configuration is being tested to understand how it can be effectively used in a battle scenario. There are several variants of 50 caliber round used by the US military. This includes rounds like M8, which is designed for armor piercing, and rounds like MK211, intended to perforate or penetrate hardened or bullet-resistant targets. So the addition of 50 caliber gun to EMAV will significantly improve the offensive capability of Marine units. Second is the addition of lethal miniature aerial missile systems, LMAMS. Lethal Miniature Aerial Missile Systems is a specialized launcher designed to fire loitering kamikaze or suicide drone. This will provide the Marines with a way to target non-line-of-sight targets, such as snipers and enemy combatants planting IEDs with precision fire. The recent attack on Saudi Arabia's Abqaiq oil processing facility, which was hit by cruise missile and suicide drones, show that rivals are getting technically advanced. It's most likely that US military could face a far more sophisticated enemy in the future, and hence it needs to stay one step ahead. The traditional warfare doctrines will have to be upgraded to meet emerging challenges, and in this regard, AI-enabled autonomous systems will be very important. Jeff Tomczak, Deputy Director of the Science and Technology, S&T, Division of the Marine Corps Warfighting Laboratory, stated, "Here again, the lab has to make sure that the robots or systems they're fielding are not a burden. If a robot comes along, a Marine has to carry tools to fix it, maintain it, or control it. So the lab is looking how to improve sustainment of robotic systems. If we give them this capability and they have to babysit it, that's a problem. He emphasized, we want to create something that's additive to the mission. It will be interesting to see how things progress.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.